But the intro's round, as it's Christmas, is a bit of a change, with all the tunes being performed by internationally celebrated musicians, ladies and gentlemen, Rick Wakeman and Bill Bailey. And your first one? And, Rick.
What?
Was that in your loft? Don't tell me you kept it in the same wardrobe all these years. I'm thinking, oh, one of these days.
Oh, I thought it'd come in useful one day.
Must have been great being his kid, though. Dad, you got any clothes in the loft we can muck about in? So, Sean, Les and Frank, here are your three. I'll give you a clue here. The second half of that was slightly misleading. We were looking more for the first half, which was the song that was on the card.
And we were supposed to be listening to that. I thought you were tuning up.
Please, think, well,
if gay men organise the London Marathon, that's what they put around their shoulders when they
Yeah, it wouldn't be called gay pride if they had to walk around like that, would it?
Shame.
Let's hear that once more.
Well, Frank turned to me and said, that's London's burning, isn't it? But I think that's fine, it's London's calling.
It is London calling, my little class. Well done.
It's
a hellraiser. It is hellraiser, by the way. And there's a man dressed so badly, looking so happy. Finally.
Do you want to know why?
Can I just...
Oh, he's had a tattoo done. Anyway, finally. I think we can all see now how Yes filled out those stadiums. That was, I can only describe, piss poor. But what do you think it might have been?
Was it Shut Up Your Face by Joe Dolce?
That's not right. I'm going to pass it
on. It sounds like the Kinks to me.
Yeah, it does to me.
It does sound a little bit like the Kinks. It's not, though.
Come on, Rick, give us a clue, Rick.
Actually, a good clue. It should have sounded like this. But it didn't! Oh. Yeah.
Well, Black Betty.
Black Beauty.
So what we had there, of course, was London Calling by The Clash. The Clash's drummer, Top Ahead, is now a cabbie in West London and bores passengers by saying, you never guess who I had in the front of my cab the other day? Me. I'm Top Ahead from The Clash. Hellraiser by The Sweet. In 1973, The Sweet admitted that they hadn't actually played on their first four hits. They were too busy doing sessions for the Bay City Rollers. and Black Betty by Ram Jam. Ram Jam consisted of guitarist Bill Bartlett, drummer Pete Charles, and singer Arthur Blofeld. No one knows what happened to the rest of the band, but Blofeld was last seen living in a hollowed-out volcano plotting world domination. As far as I know, but I haven't really looked into it. Right, Phil, Martine and Goldie, there are three intros for you.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's Duran Duran, and it's
what's the name? Save a Prayer.
The title of the song "Save a Prayer." Yeah. It is by Duran Duran. Okay, the next one. Try not to get confused by the middle eight there, but the rest of it was the right tune.
It's Sunshine of Your Love.
It's Sunshine of Your Love by Queen. And finally, looking forward to this one.
Come on now.
Time was a little bit too young, but I believe that's what they call prog rock. Yeah. You know what that song was? It was actually quite a lot of songs that weren't on the cards. So it's sort of
working our way back. We had the Adams Family theme.
That wasn't
just before the Adams Family. What was it?
It was that dreadful Mike Oldfield thing. I think it's called Portsmouth or something.
It's not called Portsmouth. I'm afraid.
Is it not?
Mark, would it help if we played it again?
Not for me, it wouldn't. No.
I'm sorry, Mark, we don't know.
Yes, I spotted that. So I'm going to pass it over.
Is it called the Something Dance? A simple yes or no will suffice.
Was it...
No.
Okay. Was it Armageddon, Tell Me What's Wrong? That one by the ABBA.
Oh.
No, we've established it's Mike Oldfield, Liz. You know when he said Mike Oldfield and I said, yes, it is Mike Oldfield?
Then you said, guessed ABBA. You said no. Did he say no? He said no. He said no. He said no. I heard him. He said no. I was here. I was there. He said no.
Is he having a relapse? Les, it's not ABBA.
It's nothing to do with ABBA.
Pretty much, because it's Mike Oldfield.
Well, who's he? Who's he? Was he in ABBA? Was he?
Yes, Les.
Oh, right.
He was.
It was actually called In Dolce Jubilo.
Oh.
So what we had there was Save a Prayer by Duran Duran. In October of this year, Duran Duran successfully sued The Sun for untrue allegations made in an offensive and mocking tone. Ooh, I'm Simon Le Bon. Ooh, I don't like offensive and mocking. Ooh, my wife's murder. Sue me, not my money. After splitting up with Amanda the Cadenae, Duran Duran's John Taylor recorded an album of love songs dedicated to his ex-wife, although the romance was obviously cooling by the time he wrote the final track. Shave your back, arseface. Sunshine of Your Love by Cream. When Eric Clapton came to prominence in the late 60s, the words Clapton is God began to appear as graffiti all around London. Slightly spoilt by the words Kevin's dad is a bender. So, what I've surmised so far is you like the ones that end with bender. And in Dolce Jubilo by Mike Oldfield. Mike Bender Oldfield. Mike Oldfield suffers from claustrophobia, agoraphobia and vertigo. He only found out when he was stuck in a ski lift. Bender. You'd like to hear a song called Bender in a Ski Lift. Have a go. Morrissey.
Yeah.
Bender in a ski lift, I know, I know. I know,
it's Bender in a ski lift.
And the B-side, shave your back, ass face.
Oh, ass face.
At the end of that round, both teams have 4 points, and while you're applauding that, a big hand for Mr. Rick Wakeman and Mr. Bill Bailey.